poll fever is rising across the country, and we are in Mumbai, which witnesses the polls on April 29. That's the fourth phase of the general elections 2019. We are right now in Savory, which houses the slum dwellings of the poshest South Mumbai locality. This South Mumbai locality faces a direct contest between the Shiv Sena MP, that's the sitting MP Arvind Sawant, and Congress candidate Milind Deora.
Mumbai South Constituency, considered the heart of the city, is now a battlefield. Newly appointed City Congress President Milind Deora versus the sitting Shiv Sena MP Arvind Sawant. For Congress, the real challenge is to revive the grand old party post-election.
Election 2019 different from the one which was in 2014?
So many ways it's different. 14, there was a semblance of a wave. People wanted a change. We were in power. This time, people are wanting a change again. People are wanting the policies of the Modi government, which have hurt people, from small traders, job seekers, average women. Inflation, unemployment, these are very serious issues, and I think this time people want a change.
But BJP is very confident, saying that they will come back and come back with a bigger majority. So what is the source of confidence of the Congress and NCP alliance?
In 2004, when Vajpayee was Prime Minister, even that time, they were very confident they'll come back with a big majority. In the media, if you watch television, it feels like BJP is invincible. What happened recently, 5 months ago in Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh, demonstrated they're not invincible. The people of India will not get fooled again and again by this kind of politics. And I can assure you that the mood on the streets of India is very different from that in studios.
But what is the main issue in this election of 2019, according to you?
Many issues. Development is the biggest issue. And the fact that the government, after 5 years of being in power, is trying to obfuscate and deviate from development and focus on emotive issues.
But don't you think that Congress is reinventing its strategy in some way or the other for this election?
I don't think there's anything on the social or religious front. Certainly on the economic front, we're presenting an alternative. And we're telling the people of India that you've been promised a lot, nothing has been delivered. In fact, things have become worse economically. You've been promised 2 crore jobs a year, but there have been crores of people who are getting unemployed. And this time people want a change.
But what is Congress promising? How are you going to source the jobs to the people which Congress is saying that BJP couldn't provide?
For one, we would not do something like demonetization. We think it's a disaster. I don't think that enough attention is given to that issue. It has caused massive havoc in the country. It's caused a lot of damage. It's caused people to be unemployed, businesses to be shut down. It's led to a banking crisis. The fact that businesses are being shut down means how will they pay loans to the banks?
But despite all that, India is one of the fastest economies growing in the world.
That doesn't mean anything. That shows you that had we not done that, we would have created jobs, we would have been even a faster growing economy. Because Congress laid the groundwork in 10 years for India to grow fast. Unfortunately, they destroyed that in the last 5 years.
But why was Congress seen in the last 2 terms which Congress was in power? It was seen as a government which suffered from policy paralysis, indecision, a lot of corruption.
10 years down the line, any party that's in power, anti-incumbency catches up. You can't help prevent that. And it caught up with us. And we also were unable or failed to communicate our strengths and counter the weaknesses. We failed, and there was an onslaught against us that Congress stands for corruption and things like that, which a court has said that 2G was not a scam. We failed to communicate. We should have communicated better. There's no doubt about it. But we've learned a lesson. But I think the people of India believed Modi in 2014. But now they've realized that just lies is not what's going to sell.
But you feel that Congress is communicating better with the people for 2019?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Okay. Coming to Mumbai Congress, now that you've are taking charge of the Mumbai chief, What kind of a responsibility is it really for you? Because you're not only taking care of the constituency
from which you say, I've just been made president a month before the elections. I believe the real work will start the day the elections are over. Right now, the candidates were already announced before I became president. They already know what's the work's cut out for them. They know their areas well. My real job will be when I take over on the 30th of April, when we change the organization, when I bring my people in, other people in, broaden the scope of the organization. That's when I think the real work will come in.
But Congress in 2014, especially talking about Mumbai, there are six Lok Sabha seats and Congress was completely wiped out. So to revive the party in all these Lok Sabha constituencies, don't you think it's going to be a tough task for you at hand?
I think the candidates are very capable. Each of the areas, the candidates know the area well. They've represented the area and they'll do their best. And I'm very confident we have good candidates. And I'm confident the voters of Mumbai this time will choose good candidates who don't have criminal cases against them, who stand for good, clean politics, who've raised issues in the past.
But there is a feeling that all the older candidates have been repeated, whom the people had rejected.
From which party?
From Congress. You're talking about the Mumbai Lok Sabha.
Nothing like that. There's our Congress. We have young candidates. We have all mix of candidates. I mean, Urmila Matondkar, Milind Deora, Priyadat are young candidates. Nothing like that. There are very senior people in BJP who've been repeated. Mr. Gopal Shetty, Mr. Gajanan Kirtikar are very senior. It's nothing to do with that. Okay. Last time people voted on a Modi wave, this time people will vote for the right candidates.
Okay, so we'll continue our conversation with Milind while he's on the campaign trail. Talking about the issues of South Mumbai, your constituency, what are the issues which are resonating on the ground there?
Many issues, issues of housing, affordable housing. South Mumbai is a hub for the trading and commerce for India. If you look at diamond industry, gold industry, cloth industry, so many industries, local industries are based in South Mumbai, which affect the entire country. All of these industries have been very, very severely affected by policies of this government in the last 5 years. And all of these industries and businessmen operating in these industries, people who are in need of affordable housing, from Girni Kamgars, who are the mill workers, to what we call Bhade Crews, who are the tenants, to people living in slums. The last 5 years, none of the MPs of Mumbai have raised these issues in Parliament.
But Milind, are you trying to say that none of these MPs have raised these issues and plus the centrally sponsored schemes have not reached these people at all?
Not at all, not at all, not at all. And in fact, there's been a massive detachment and disconnect from what the government is announcing and advertising and what's actually reached the people.
But just to give you a small example, your Mumbai North Central BJP MP Poonam Mahajan, she has an immaculate, impeccable record as an MP. She's spent most of her MPLAT funds, debate participation she has raised so many questions. So how do you say that MPs have not raised the issues?
Look, asking...
That is just one example.
Asking questions about whether a mandir or masjid will be built, how does that affect the common man here? Just simply looking at somebody's attendance record, if you as a person if you attend your office every day but don't do anything, then equal doing something. It's what you do, it's the quality of your journalism, it's the quality of your question, not the number of times you asked a question. And the unfortunate part is they fail to raise local issues.
Owing to rapid development in Mumbai South, areas around are facing massive congestion, lanes have become narrower, waterlogging is a huge issue, and the Mumbai Port Trust eviction is also a poll issue this election.
2014 aur 2019 ke elections mein aapki zindagi mein kya farak pada?
Koi kuch farak nahi pada abhi to. Jaise pehle waise aaj bhi hu.
Kuch bhi nahi badla, sab note band kiya, sab band kiya, kya hai? जिधर का उधर ही पढ़े ले हम लोग।
मिलिंद, Is it really a daunting task for you to carry on the legacy of your father, Murli Deora, who's worked through his constituency so much?
No, it's not a daunting task. It's a humbling task to be given the same responsibility as him. And it's something I'm trying to fulfill to the best of my abilities and have been since 2004.
But Milind, coming to the alliances which have been formed, is Congress not adopting the same formula and the same strategy which BJP had adopted in 2014?
No, I don't think so. I think we're doing our best to build an alliance. We've been doing that so far. We're still in the process of forming up some alliances.
Is it really a difficult task to carry on the legacy of Mr. Murli Deora now?
I don't think it's, I wouldn't say it's difficult. It's a humbling, it's humbling to have been given the responsibilities that he has. And when I got into parliament at the age of 2004, that for me was a humbling experience, to get into parliament at such a young age and to represent, I believe is India's most prestigious constituency. So I try and take it in my stride and do the best that I can.
But given the responsibilities you have, like you are heading the Mumbai Congress as well, so how much time are you really able to devote to other constituencies in Mumbai?
Well, I've just become president of Mumbai Congress, so we can't expect any miracles. I don't have a team. I haven't changed anyone. Mm-hmm. So I'm not really, I think the real work will begin for me after the election's over. Okay. Each of the candidates who are fighting the elections were announced before I became president. They're fully aware of their constituencies, their experience, they know the area well. And so I'm confident that they're running the election in the best of their abilities. Whatever support Mumbai Congress can give them at a centralized level, we're doing that.
But just a few months ago, we saw an ugly spat between you, because you tweeted against Sanjay Nirupam, not in very open terms, but you did tweet that Sanjay Nirupam was running the Congress party as a one-man army. So why do you think the things went wrong?
No, I didn't tweet he's running it like a one-man army. I said that there were issues in the party and there are issues in every organization. Those things are behind us. We're very united, working unitedly. Everyone, all the leaders of Mumbai are working very unitedly. We have a single agenda. Wherever he has people who can help me or other people, he's doing that. If I have people who can help other candidates, we're telling them to help. So everyone's working as one team.
So on the ground, media, like the way media is perceiving that there is a Milind Deora camp and not a Sanjay Nirupam camp?
Not at all. We are all united. Look, every organization has differences. Mm-hmm. And ultimately, does an organization have the ability to put differences aside for a larger purpose? Okay. And that's something we've been able to do. Okay. And we may have differences of opinions, different working styles. That doesn't mean you have a personal enmity. That doesn't mean you have some groupism. That means you want to sort of, people fight for their space in politics. But today, everyone's put their difference aside. I'm seeing great unity between all workers, leaders of the party.
I'll take you back now to my question earlier also, which I asked, was on the political arithmetic in Maharashtra. Why do you think was the need to ally with NCP, with whom you had parted ways in the last elections? And then now you're also allying with smaller parties. So what is the most compulsive need, you know, for this?
With NCP, we hadn't parted ways. We were together in the parliament, last parliament election.
Right.
So we've been traditional allies since 1999. Mm-hmm. The assembly election of 2014 was the only election where we fought separately. Otherwise, we've been fighting together ever since. In parliament, in assembly. So I don't see them as a compulsion. I mean, they're a natural ally.
But will you not concede to the fact that both NCP and Congress realize that they cannot fight BJP all by themselves, and probably that's a need why you came together?
No, I don't think so. I think that we have a arrangement with NCP, which is a very comfortable, well-coordinated alliance based on similar ideologies. Ultimately, NCP came out of the Congress party.
Right.
It's very different from, say, a Shiv Sena and BJP who've been abusing each other for the last 5 years. Mm-hmm. And where Shiv Sena has launched or had launched in the last 5 years a far uglier, more personal attack on the Prime Minister, on the President of the BJP, on the government, than even opposition parties had. And today they are suddenly praising the Prime Minister. So that hypocrisy of theirs is actually, you know, sticking out like a sore thumb in terms of people are asking that question, what happened to just 1 month ago you were criticizing them and abusing them, and now what's changed?
But would you not also concede to the fact that Congress somewhere down the line, if you talk about Maharashtra and also across the country, the way the alliances have been stitched, Congress has not been able to come out as a party which is at the center of all the alliances, looking at states after states?
No, we've tried to stitch together alliances with all parties. Mm-hmm. Some parties don't want to come, didn't want to join us. That's a different issue.
Some parties also say that aligning with Congress is okay, but then we don't want to see Rahul Gandhi as a Prime Minister.
Well, we haven't announced a Prime Minister yet.
Okay.
And neither did we announce a Prime Minister in 2004. Mm-hmm. So these are just excuses. Some parties are ideologically are concerned about us. They're concerned about us taking their space. That's why they may not have aligned. Some parties are really working as B teams of the BJP or Shiv Sena in Maharashtra or elsewhere. So I don't see that as any meaning. I mean, to me, it's more of we tried our best. We tried to stitch together a large alliance.
Okay.
It's worked out to the best of our abilities. We are confident that the alliance will work. I remember we didn't have alliances with parties like Mayawati and Samajwadi in Uttar Pradesh even in 2004 and 2009. But we still came to power.
But the way the narrative is developing in 2019, do you think that the political narrative is about chemistry or it's about
the
politics?
Is very different on the streets of India as it is in studios.
Okay.
And in media. I think it's very, very different. And to me, it's very similar to 2004, where if I put on a TV channel or I pick up a newspaper,
mm-hmm.
also the media is, let's be honest, the media in general is very sort of, they're under pressure from this government. It's working very differently than it's worked in the past. And as a result of that, the media is showing a story which is not true. It's distorting the story.
So are you saying that media is biased?
Absolutely. Some sections are, yes. A lot of sections are. Or under pressure, for whatever reason. Either they have a bias, either there's an ideological bias, which is fine. Which in my view, people are entitled to an ideological bias.
Right.
But I think that there are certain sections which are under pressure and are being forced to sort of show a certain story.
Mm-hmm.
And but that may not be the story on the ground.
But Milind, another reality of the media is a social media. But we don't see too many pro-Congress voices on social media as well.
Social media, you'll find a far more balanced view of what's happening in the country with regards to Congress versus the other parties as you will in the mainstream media. And that clearly means that where there's a filter of editors, owners, there are certain forces at play.
Okay. But the communication strategy has been built by Congress. You came out with the Nyai scheme and the way the films and the ad campaigns around Nyai have been built. I don't see it much percolating on the ground the way the Congress leaders are communicating to the people. When it comes to communicating about Nyai, that's not happening enough. Why so?
I don't think that's true. I think we're doing our best to communicate our plans, our strengths,
mm-hmm.
what we intend to do.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that people already know what we stand for socially.
Okay.
They know what we stand for economically.
Mm-hmm.
People have seen that in the last 5 years. People are smart also.
Mm.
People know that in the last 5 years, oil prices were the lowest ever globally, crude oil prices. But yet, the cost of an LPG cylinder is 1,000 rupees today.
Mm-hmm.
People know that when we were in power, the cost of crude oil, a barrel was $120, double of what it is today.
So if you have to explain to the people in one line what Nyai is all about, how would you translate it?
I would say it's basically a safety net for people to get a form of minimum income.
Mm-hmm.
and where their income is supplemented by the government.
But that safety net is already being provided by BJP through many other subsidies
not,
and
not
schemes.
Not working, not reaching the ground. Tell me, as a taxpayer, you pay for Swachh Bharat.
Okay.
You and I pay for Swachh Bharat. Is our taxpayer money going to good use? We pay for, as taxpayers, for Air India. Is our taxpayer money being put to good use? Are cities, villages getting cleaner or dirtier? I'm seeing Mumbai is getting dirtier by the day.
Milind, there are a lot of X factors in this election. We'll just take about three minutes more. There are a lot of X factors in this election, and so many Congress leaders with whom I spoke to, they said that, you know, there's an X factor called MNS, which is supporting and, collaborating Congress cadres, and, you know, they're providing emotional support. So how potential is the MNS factor for Congress in this election?
There are a lot of parties which are supporting us, in Mumbai especially. There's MNS, there's AAP, there's CPIM, there's Janata Dal. They've all expressed their support. I see them in rallies, joining us, working with us. We're welcoming anyone's support. That doesn't mean we have an alliance with them. People want to come and campaign against Narendra Modi's government, against Shiv Sena. That's their prerogative.
But if you have to build a political narrative around the support of so many parties, the one question which comes to the mind of the people is, who is going to be your leader? There are too many people.
I don't think there's a question with any of these parties. These parties are not saying, make us the leader. I don't think when Aam Aadmi Party is supporting me in South Mumbai, they're saying, make me the leader. Or when CPIM is supporting us, they're saying, make me the leader.
No, but when you talk about a Mahagadbandhan or maybe some kind of an alliance, then obviously you have to project some leader. Like you have a Mamata Banerjee, you have a Sharad Pawar, you have a Chandrababu Naidu, you have a KCR. Everybody seems to be on their own trip.
I don't think that matters. I think that that's very different. You're talking about alliance partners and you're talking about, we have an alliance with Chandrababu Naidu. We don't have an alliance with CPIM, MNS, Janata Dal or AAP right now.
Right.
So there are two very different things.
But Congress did try to stitch up a grand alliance, which didn't happen.
That's a different issue. The parties coming out and saying, we don't want Narendra Modi to become Prime Minister again, or we are against their policies, is very different from saying we're having a pre-poll alliance with Congress.
Right.
So that's people coming to us and saying, we want to support you. They're public coming and saying, we want to support you.
So you mean to say that for Congress, Narendra Modi is the biggest enemy?
Not for Congress only, for many other people, for parties who are not even part of the Congress alliance. Their aim is, we won't put a candidate, but we want to help Congress win.
But who matches up to Narendra Modi then, if the entire campaign is against
him? I don't think that the issue of who matches up to Narendra Modi is what's important. I don't think it's a matter of, is it Modi versus X? I think Modi versus X, Mandir versus Masjid, national versus anti-national, these are just spins and diversions.
See,
I'll tell you, now for example, you and I have been talking for 15 minutes. Besides Nyay, even the media, we're not talking about core issues that matter to this country. We haven't talked about employment, we haven't talked about jobs, we haven't talked about demonetization. When I talk to media, I haven't heard one question on those issues.
No, but when you talk about jobs, their jobs are coming through various sources, but we don't have a proper data because there are multiple agencies who are...
And because the government has hidden the data, right? So the point I'm making is, where is the media talking about substantive issues that matter?
No, but which is the credible agency according to you? Because there are multiple agencies working on the data.
Was demonetization a disaster? Was it a disaster?
No, but has it not brought in transparency? Has it not brought in reforms?
What reforms?
More digitization?
At the cost of unemployment and loss to the economy.
And so Congress is now promising the moon to the people that...
No. I'm saying, why are these not issues? Why is Narendra Modi versus X, why is Mandir Masjid an issue?
I never asked you a question on Mandir, but I'm definitely going to ask you one question.
The problem is, the media is buying into a spin. Either they're doing it because they have to do it, either they're doing it because they want to do it.
See, we are not under pressure.
No, whatever.
Otherwise, I wouldn't have interviewed Milind Deora.
I'm saying is, the media is getting into a distraction, is getting distracted, and the core issues are going away. See, you have to move beyond personalities. You have to focus on issues. Earlier, what was the narrative in the country? Mandir or Masjid. Then it was national or anti-national. Then it's stable or weak government.
No, but if you're talking, you spoke about
I'm asking you. You know, I'm just asking the question is, they may be important issues, but I'm more concerned about how will my young brothers and sisters get jobs? What's the state of our education in our country? What's the state of healthcare in our country? What are women's issues women's safety, what is our foreign policy? Those to me are very serious issues. One last question.
You spoke about nationalism. So for you, how important is the internal security? Because your party has been saying that you want to review ASPA.
I think that if, for me, the biggest national security is that if policies like demonetization, which have hurt our youth, and if we are failing to convert a demographic advantage into a demographic dividend, and we're converting it into a liability, I think that is one of India's biggest national security problems.
To start with, we would not do a thing like demonetization,
which was a massive surgical strike on India. Thank you.
Are you saying that if Congress comes back to power, you're going to roll back the whole
exercise? I'm saying that how can we roll back demonetization? How can we roll it back? How do you roll it back?
So supposing if it is that big an ill, how will you reverse the ill?
You criticize and you vote against parties who did that. You vote against parties who are politicizing the armed forces. What's the difference between India and Pakistan today? Both countries were formed on the same day. Why is it that Pakistan's army has staged a coup against the government many times?
I was coming to that
Why
question.
Is it that India's army has never staged a coup against the government?
No, but when India does an airstrike, there are political parties who are questioning that what has the army done?
70 years of India's independence, which were run by Congress for a large portion, one of the biggest advantages of the Congress party was that we kept the armed forces out of politics, which prevented the armed forces from even staging a coup against the government as has happened in Pakistan. Unfortunately today, the first time I'm seeing a civilian government politicizing the armed forces, demanding votes in the names of armed forces, that's very uncalled for. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you so much. Congress and BJP are trying to build a narrative, but what are the issues resonating on the ground and what do the people feel? Let me find out from some people here in South Mumbai. आप साउथ मुंबई के रहने वाले
हैं? मुंबई लालबाग के।
पिछले पांच साल का अगर आप आकलन करें तो क्या बोलेंगे जो मौजूदा सरकार है उसने कैसा काम किया?
मोदी ने बहुत अच्छा काम किया है और मोदी आने अच्छे हैं। मोदी आने अच्छे बस।
कुछ और भी लोग हैं हमारे साथ, उनसे बात करते हैं। अभी का जो चुनाव है उसके बारे में आपका क्या कहना है? क्या पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज मुद्दे उठा रही हैं?
हाँ, बेसिकली थोड़े थोड़े उठा रहे, पर मेन टॉपिक्स तो लाइक यूथ को जो जॉब्स रहना चाहिए उसके ऊपर नहीं बात कर रहे, बाकी क्योंकि सब मतलब सोशल, जैसे कि ये नेता इसमें इसने ये बोल दिया, ये कमेंट किया, ये सब बातें हो रही है। जहाँ पे यूथ के लिए बातें होनी चाहिए, उन लोग को जॉब प्रोवाइड करना चाहिए, उन लोग के लिए क्या नए प्लान्स डेवलप कर रहे हैं वो इम्पोर्टेंट है।
आपके हिसाब से जैसे जो बालाकोट में एयर स्ट्राइक हुई वो भी एक बहुत बड़ा मुद्दा है कि किस तरह से भारत की सरकार ने एक हिम्मती और साहसी कदम उठाया और एक एयर स्ट्राइक की, आतंकवादियों को मुंह तोड़ जवाब देना, क्या वो एक चुनावी मुद्दा भी
नहीं? क्योंकि वो अगर इंडियन, वो एक्चुअली किसी पॉलिटिकल के लिए स्टैंड नहीं लेना चाहिए, क्योंकि वो इंडिया का स्टैंड है, इंडियन आर्मी को ही करना चाहिए। उसमें पॉलिटिक्स अपना फ़ायदा कि नहीं मेरे सरकार है तो मैंने ये किया है, ये नहीं लेना चाहिए, क्योंकि वो एट द एंड इंडिया है, स्टैंड कर रहा है ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड।
तो कुछ लोगों का ये मानना है कि ये इंडियन आर्मी का कदम है और इसे एक चुनावी मुद्दा नहीं बनाना चाहिए। आप भी साउथ मुंबई के ही हो। अच्छा, ये बताइए कि जो कांग्रेस और बीजेपी का जो अलायंस है और उसमें एमएनएस भी बहुत साथ दे रहा है इसमें, कांग्रेस और जो पूरा गठबंधन इन्होंने बनाया है, लेकिन ज़मीनी हकीकत क्या लग रही है आपको? क्या प्रॉपर मुद्दे उठाए जा रहे हैं? क्या पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज असली मुद्दों पर बात कर रही हैं?
जो मेन मुद्दा है कांग्रेस के राज में खाओ और खिलाओ, और बीजेपी में ना खाओ ना ही खिलाओ। जो भी है बीजेपी के सपोर्ट में ही है। आज यहाँ पे जैसे आप हमारे एरिया में आए हो, मेरे को भी 40 साल हो गए यहाँ पे, और जैसे पहले कांग्रेस थी लेकिन यहाँ पे शिवसेना ही आई है, कभी कांग्रेस आई नहीं है, बराबर। अभी गठबंधन हो गया है शिवसेना का, तो भी बीजेपी ही आने गई और बहुत भारी मतों से आएगी।
चलिए, अब इस समय मैं और आप तो इस बात का फैसला नहीं कर सकते हैं, बट Mumbai goes to polls on April 29 and that's the day when the citizens of this constituency will seal the future of the candidates. From Mumbai, this is Neenu Vyas.